Hi everybody, this is Bob Whitaker from History Respawn, doing a little bit of streaming tonight on the new DLC from Assassin's Creed Syndicate called The Last Maharaja, which focuses on the story of Duleep Singh, who was briefly figured into the main story, the main campaign for this game, but is getting his own DLC treatment. Here in, I guess what you might say, I think it's the last DLC package for Assassin's Creed Syndicate. So for those of you who don't know, I run a YouTube series called History Respawn, in which historians take a look at historical video games, and this is, I think it's the fifth video in a series of videos that I've done on Assassin's Creed Syndicate, and just to give you a fair warning, I received this game for free from Ubisoft in order to do a review of it. So that just gives you a little bit of a sense of where I'm coming from. Again, it doesn't really affect how I perceive the game. So I am already through the main campaign. So if you haven't played Syndicate yet and you might be a little bit worried about spoilers, this is your last warning for that. So, I have, as you can see from the map, I've completed a lot of the side content, not through the Thames and also through Westminster, but through most of the other areas, I've completed a lot of the side content already. So, again, this is the Last Maharaja DLC, so I think this S here for Singh as the beginning of the missions. So what I'm going to do is just kind of focus on this storyline and see where it takes me. So I need to find out where I am. Okay, so I'm in the Strand. Make my way down to Westminster District. So it has been several months since I picked up this game, so if my play here is a little bit rusty, that's the reason. I think I completed the main storyline back in December, and I would say on the whole I really enjoyed the game, but didn't really have much of a reason to come back until the new DLC came out, and this Last Maharaja DLC came out last week. There was also the DLC for Jack the Ripper, which is actually kind of a separate campaign, which is accessed from the main menu, and it's a campaign that takes place about 10 years after the events of the main Syndicate storyline. But this DLC for The Last Maharaja takes place in, I guess, the month or so after the main storyline concludes. And I'm really interested in playing the DLC, primarily because I think the two pieces of DLC that have come out are going to address the two main criticisms that I had of the original game. And in the regular version of Assassin's Creed Syndicate, there was very little reference to prostitution, which was, of course, a major part of cultural life during the Victorian era. And I believe that's addressed in the Jack the Ripper DLC. And then my second main criticism, which I think is addressed in this DLC, is the fact that there really isn't much mention of the British Empire, despite the fact that the game is set in the very height of the British Empire in the 1860s. So I'm hoping this Last Maharaja DLC will give us a chance, at least in these 10 missions that are included in the DLC pack, give us a chance to see how Ubisoft, the makers of this game, have attempted to deal with imperialism. A nice game of cricket going on here to the right. And, you know, 1867, when this game is set, it's the, like I said, the height of the British Empire. This is with Britain has taken control over a huge proportion of the world colonies in Asia, in the Indies, also beginning to take over colonial areas in Africa as well. And it was remarkable to me playing the original game, or the base version of Syndicate, that not more was made of Empire, not just in the wider world, but also within the city of London. Because like I argued in past, live streams, the Empire was really present within the city of London, but you don't see much of that within this game. You don't see many people of color. You don't see many people who you would think would have a imperial background to come from somewhere else. So I'm really curious to see how they deal with Duleep Singh. And unfortunately, I've gotten attention from one of these gang members. I'll take out real fast here. Of course, there's more than one. There we go. Okay. Now I can get back to my lecture. So this storyline, again, it focuses on Duleep Singh. And Duleep Singh is an interesting character from the Victorian age. He was the so-called last Maharaja, the Maharaja of the Sikh Empire. And the Sikh Empire was located primarily in an area of India known as the Punjab. And the Punjab is located in what is now northwest India. But really, it took up space along what is now the India-Pakistan border. And in the Punjab, you had the Sikhs. And during the early 19th century, basically from 1800 until the 1830s, the Sikh Empire was ruled by Duleep Singh's father, named Ranjit Singh. And Ranjit had managed to gain a large area of the Punjab for Sikh control, and rule this area basically without much interference from the British Empire, which was quite an achievement, especially for a princely state in the early 19th century. Unfortunately, for the Sikhs and for Duleep, the death of Ranjit in the late 1830s brought about the collapse of the Sikh Empire, and there was attempts to maintain the empire under Duleep's control, but he had only been born about a year before his father's death. So basically he was put in charge of an empire that he was too young to rule. And so in the late 1840s, the British came in. They took control over the Sikh Empire, what remained of the Sikh Empire. And they took Duleep and they sent him off to exile in Britain. And this was a pretty popular tactic for the British dealing with states or colonies that they were concerned would eventually turn against them or rebel. So they sent Duleep to Britain, to live in Britain, in the early 1850s. So the main character of this storyline for this DLC, Duleep Singh, he's somebody who has control, or should have control, over an empire. But unfortunately, he's had that control taken away from him by the British, and he's essentially being held in Britain from the 1850s until the early 1880s as somewhat of a prisoner. And so at the time this game is set, 1867, Duleep has been living in Britain since the early 1850s. He's acculturated as a British subject. He has taken on British dress. He's developed a habit as a British gentleman. He rides horses. He is famous for being very good at shooting, sports shooting. But it's during the 1860s that he begins to agitate the British crown. Queen Victoria in particular begins to agitate the British crown and the British government for a return of the Sikh Empire, a return of what he sees as his rightful lands within northwest India. So with that as a preface, let me go ahead and get started with these missions.
Attempts to influence Parliament for the Indian cause have failed. You must do more.
I will not jeopardize my relationship with Queen and country to satisfy your crusade.
Your Highness, you belong to India, not here acting the part of a noble foreigner.
I have wasted enough time indulging in this
nonsense. Your mother could see you now, the last Maharaja of Punjab, basking inside his golden cage.
How dare you?
So, he references Duleep's mother, and that's really important because his mother is somebody who was pushing Duleep to try to push for control over his former lands. But unfortunately, she was never able to convince Duleep to kind of push for these goals. When Duleep's mother died in the early 1860s, it was that moment that he attempted to begin to push Parliament, begin to push the British government for return of his native lands in northwest India, in the Punjab. The thing that's interesting about the portrayal of Duleep in this game is the fact that you see him walking around with his ceremonial royal Sikh dress on, but by the mid, 1860s, late 1860s, when this game is set, Duleep is somebody who is actually acculturated to Western styles of living, Western styles of dress. Like I said, he had developed a habit as English writer, as a sports shooter, somebody who would become basically an English gentleman. And so very often you would see him not in this ceremonial Sikh garb, but instead you would see him wearing Western suits, Western style, yes, European suits.
I suppose Mr. Green sent you.
Bringing up your mother was...
impolite, and he was wrong to do so. We'd like to rectify the situation.
Then humor me, and join me in a shooting game. None of these people have any sense of enjoyment, and I am bored to death.
A shooting game? Seeing you haven't changed at all.
Ellsworth? My word! How good it is to see you! The mother country has treated you well. Jacob and Evie Fry, this is Brinley Ellsworth, a friend from a past life.
You've made new friends, I see.
What brings you to this part of the empire?
Company business, unfortunately. But I could not resist the chance of seeing you again. It's been far too long. I've heard nobody throws a party better than my dearest friend. I'm eager to see if your reputation overseas holds any truth.
So by the 1860s, Duleep Singh had developed a reputation
My
as
servant Thomas will be scoring the game.
Not necessarily a playboy, but somebody who enjoyed to throw his wealth around.
Points by shooting the bottles in front of you. Each bottle is worth 1 point. You have 30 seconds. May the best shot win. Start the timer.
Concentrate for this section. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to shoot the cups or just the bottles. Shoot the targets. I guess there must be more.
7 points.
Well, that's not bad.
Come, Thomas. This isn't enough of a challenge. Let's shorten the timer.
Round two will now commence. Try and do as well, if not better, within a 20-second time limit. Timer at the ready. Begin!
So I'm not sure about sports shooting during the Victorian age. It wouldn't have been uncommon to have events like this at aristocratic parties. I'm not sure about shooting bottles off of tables. That seems kind of a bit boring. They would have probably shot at something that moved instead, a little bit more sporting. Than you were with a slingshot.
Allow me.
Wow, okay. Oof.
Sir, I believe I heard a second shot.
He's right. That sounded like a second gunshot. Strange.
Let me see what I can find out.
I'm sure it wasn't anything serious. Don't bother.
Interesting. Well, this looks like we're doing some sort of investigation here. Looks like maybe there was just another shot that came in. Let's see, so all of these match up with the original shots. So it must be that one off to the left. That's different. Yeah, let's go check that out. A barrel is hot. Okay. Suspects met. Huh. Okay. Well, let's see if this guy knows anything about the shot.
What are you on about? Guns are prohibited in the gardens.
Huh. Okay.
What are you on about? Guns are prohibited in the gardens.
Well, I can't select different topic, so I guess this must not be the guy. Let's try her. Handgun?
I saw the man in front of me with a gun. I just assumed it was part of the decor. You know how royalty likes to socialize.
With guns, apparently. Okay. So let's see if we can't go back to this guy and see what he says.
That prince is causing problems. He deserves to be silenced.
Kill him!
Whoa.
I'll break you in half!
You too will be...
This is where your fun and games come to an end!
This is one of the more interesting parts about this game is that they've included women as members of gangs or as bodyguards, and sometimes it still catches me off guard as a veteran of the Assassin's Creed series, in which up until this point only men have been the members of gangs or somebody who could cause violence. So I need to interrogate the shooter. I don't know if I need to sneak up on him or not. So we don't have a sense of motivation here, but what I would imagine is that he is a member of a company from the Punjab or somewhere else in India that is concerned about Duleep Singh perhaps leading a new rebellion against British control. So it says here, a clothing patch of the British India Company, BIC, in his pocket, a Templar ring. So that must be the connection, or the desire on the part of that guy to assassinate Duleep Singh. And there was a bit of concern in the 1860s about members of the Indian aristocracy, the Maharajas, the kings of the princely states. There was a bit of concern that they would attempt to lead another mutiny. And just 10 years prior to the beginning of this game, in 1857, 1858, there had been the famous Indian Rebellion, Indian Mutiny, in which, you know, a large portion of that colony had rebelled against British rule, eventually unsuccessfully. But, you know, only 10 years after that, there would still be a great deal of concern in the 1860s, late 1860s, about British power waning in India, and perhaps another opportunity for the Indians themselves to regain control over their homelands. So Duleep Singh, as far as I know, he was never really considered to be that much of a threat. Again, like I said earlier, he is somebody who's very much accepted, or at least outwardly, he's accepted life as an English gentleman. And of course, his livelihood here, as a party goer, as somebody who's living this aristocratic lifestyle, his lifestyle is being supported by the British government. He is basically a hostage of the British, but he's also being subsidized by the British Colonial Office, or rather the British Indian Office, who's providing him with his funding to live this lifestyle. So on the one hand, he is somebody who feels this draw towards India, towards the Punjab, to regain control of his land. But
about that second shot,
at the same time, he is somebody who is enjoying a really high-class lifestyle in England.
Apologies, Your Highness.
So we're not really sure yet what the Templars are up to, but I would imagine that they are probably behind this British India Company attempt on the life of Duleep Singh. Let's see what Henry Green has to say.
Any progress?
We've got a problem. We aren't the only ones seeking him out.
Don't tell me the British Indies Company's harassing him again. They can't afford it.
Worse, they're not acting alone. And Mr. Singh wants to be left out of it.
The Templars? It can't be.
We have to convince him to act quickly, or he'll be in deeper waters than he already is.
Meet me back at my old shop. I might know something that can help.
Ah, I didn't achieve the best score. Apparently I would not have made it as an English gentleman sports shooter, but that's... it's neither here nor there. Okay, well, let's take a look at the map. Let's see where the next mission is. Again, I'm playing through the Last Maharaja DLC. This is apparently the last DLC for Assassin's Creed Syndicate. And it came out, I believe, last week. And so now I'm going to take on the second mission in that. Let's see if there is a fast travel. I think this is the only fast travel in Whitechapel. Oh, okay. Well, let's take this, because I'm not riding carriage all the way to White Castle from Westminster. So again, Last Maharaja, Duleep Singh, somebody who has a conflicted relationship with Victorian England. On the one hand, he is somebody who's had his lands taken away by the British, but on the other hand, he's lived a high-class aristocratic lifestyle as an exile in Britain. And, you know, during his life, when he arrived in Britain in the 1850s in particular, when he was a young man, he developed a close friendship with Queen Victoria. And she had a lot of respect for Duleep Singh, not only because of his stature within Indian society, within Sikh society in particular, but also because of what was seen as kind of his tragic story, that he was the heir to his father's throne, but because of British rule in the area, but and also because of the kind of internal conflicts within the Punjab at the time, he had lost control over that land. And so he's somebody who's kind of taken in by Queen Victoria as somewhat of a curiosity, but also because he was royalty. And the British, despite the fact that they, of course, sought to take control over colonies, despite the fact that they sought to take over control over strategic interests, economic interests around the world, they did still have a respect for local leaders. And this is partly because they felt that it was going to be easier to control these colonies if they maintained the local leadership whenever possible. And this is an idea that's referred to as indirect rule by the British who control the colonies. They feel that the colonies are much better, are much easier to control if they are still, in some respects, controlled by their local leaders, people who know the land, people who know the people. But these local leaders need to be made completely subservient to the wishes of the British. So it may have been the case that Queen Victoria felt that it was important to maintain a relationship with Duleep Singh because she wanted to rule the Punjab eventually using Duleep. But as time went on, the British were able to develop a new set of local leaders, and these local leaders did require or didn't necessarily desire the presence of Duleep Singh, somebody who would have acted again as the Maharaja, the king, the great king of the region, and may have with, you know, taken away power from those local Punjab leaders who had been installed by the British after the fall of Duleep's empire. So here we are in Whitechapel. We're going to meet Henry Green for the second mission in this DLC. Let's see what Henry's got for us.
Good, you're here.
River carriage to ambush location. Okay.
This isn't the first time His Highness has had troubles with the British Indies Company. A couple of years ago, they held his mother captive and blocked all his letters to her. Odds are they're keeping his correspondence from reaching the outside world once again. I have acquired the mail courier schedule. There are two separate routes of transport. The first, a mail carrying carriage convoy. The second, a train. If we set up an ambush, you should be able to seize his letters. Maybe this will change his mind. Start with the convoy. We must block the road.
Okay, so Henry Green's telling us that the British government, or somebody, the Templars perhaps, are trying to prevent Duleep Singh from sending letters to the Punjab, and perhaps trying to incite some sort of revolt against British rule, which, you know, again, Duleep Singh was somebody who was seen as kind of acculturated into British society, Victorian society, so I don't think they would have had much concern about it, but maybe some of the people controlling the companies that were in the Punjab would be concerned. And, you know, there's good reason for the British to be covetous of the Punjab. It's a really critical area in India. Again, it's located in what is now Northwest India. At the time, it overlapped the land that would become India and then Pakistan. And it's an area that is critical because it forms the beginnings of major river systems that run through what is now Pakistan, in particular the Indus River. And then also it borders, just to the northwest, it borders Afghanistan, which at the time was a site for numerous attacks by Afghan tribes, was kind of a strategic site to try to maintain control over other areas of India. There was an assumption on the part of the British that if India was to be taken away by a foreign power or to be destabilized by Afghan tribes, it would be an attack that would come from the northwest. And when the British took control over the Punjab in 1848, they essentially made a huge strategic mistake, because the Punjab was an area under the Sikh Empire that had managed to maintain control over that territory that bordered the Afghan tribal area. And when the British took it over, it became their responsibility to try to defend that region from the Afghan tribes. And in addition, the British became increasingly concerned during the late 1840s going into the 1850s that this region would also be the site for an invasion by Tsarist Russia. There was constant concerns during the mid to late 19th century that the Tsarist regime in Russia was covetous of British rule of India and would attempt to lead an offensive through Afghanistan, through the Khyber Pass, and take control of India from the British. So, in actuality, the British, when they took over the Punjab, they did so because they were desirous of new territories, particularly to the northwest. But at the same time, after they did so, it opened up a whole new layer of problems that they probably could have avoided had they maintained Duleep Singh and his family as rulers of that territory.
There you are. Anyone,
give us a penny. The mail convoy will be here any minute now. Scout the area for allies. I will guard the area.
Okay, I've got to recruit some of my guys. This is kind of a fun mechanic from the base game, is recruiting allies. This is something that was a big part of Assassin's Creed Brotherhood in particular. And I'm glad it's back here, because I think it kind of gives you a sense that, this Assassin's group is more significant and more of a growing concern than it is if you're just acting on your own. So it looks like I need to recruit more men. I'm not sure how many I'm supposed to recruit, but I'll go ahead and get three.
The convoy is headed our way.
Stay with Henry.
Understood.
Will do.
Okay, find Duleep's letters. Uh-oh, well. So these are some pretty serious opponents, as you can see they're all level 10. think I want to say that I'm level 10 as well. I'm not sure, actually. Yeah, with all this fighting going on, I'm not sure exactly. Oh, I think Henry Green went down. I'm not sure exactly who's being ambushed in this situation. I think the purpose of this is I'm supposed to sneak up and open up the back of that carriage, but unfortunately, I was detected. We'll see what happens when we retry this again. One of the downsides of having allies in games like Assassin's Creed is that they're usually not particularly adept at staying alive, and so it causes situations where you have to restart missions even though you're still fighting.
The convoy is headed our way.
Stay with Henry.
Understood.
Will do.
Penny for me and my boy.
These enemies are something else. It'd be much easier if these guys weren't so high level. Oh, I hope that wasn't me who just ran over Henry Green. Oh, jeez. Okay, I think the... looks like I'm just gonna have to attack these Templars in the streets. I don't think it's really done me any good. Oh, sorry, horse. One of my allies is almost dead. Oh, Henry Green. Come on, man. This is pretty terrible. Well, I would love to play more of these missions, but unfortunately, if they're tied to keeping allies alive, which again is not really a strong suit of Assassin's Creed, I don't know how many of these last Maharaja missions I'm actually going to end up playing. It's a pretty miserable experience so far. Okay, third time is a charm for this.
The convoy is headed our way.
Stay with Henry.
Understood.
Will do.
Okay, my plan now is to stay close to Henry Green.
You're dead. You're dead.
Oh. Oh. So here I am trying to defend Henry Green, and then I get killed myself. Wonderful. Fantastic. What a mess.
The convoy is headed our way.
Stay with Henry. Understood.
Will do.
And like I said, you know, it's nice to have allies in these games, but you know, when it's tied to trying to keep them alive and make sure they don't die, especially in these kind of circumstances, it really becomes difficult. I don't think there's any way you can upgrade Henry Green's armor or his health, which is kind of too bad, because it would be really nice in these kind of circumstances. Man, it looks like Henry Green's about to die again. Ugh. I am afraid to say this might be the end of this stream. I cannot handle this mission. So which Assassin's Creed would have to be my favorite? I started the series with Assassin's Creed 2, and I would say that probably is still my favorite game. I did really enjoy Brotherhood as well. And I would say Syndicate, this game, rates pretty highly as well, but I'd say 2. Is probably my favorite. Yes, I did notice the name of the East Indies Company being changed. I think I'm not sure why they did that. I mean, by this time, 1867, the East India Company itself has been disbanded and no longer controls India, and it's now mostly under direct control by the India office in the UK. And my guess is the reason why they changed it to the British Indies Company is to give kind of a fake cover company for the Templars in this game. Henry Green's dead again. Oh, I'm really sorry to put you all through this. Thanks for joining me on this stream. I think what I might have to do is try using more smoke bombs. Just shoot all of the enemies you can shoot dynamite to. Okay, that's a good suggestion. I'll try to do that. I think I saw dynamite up on the roofs. Above the alleyway. I wonder if there's some down on the street.
The convoy is headed our way.
Stay with Henry. Understood.
Will do.
Yeah, I think a lot of people lost interest after the third one. Not exactly the series' strongest game.
Thank you.
My ally is under attack and I'm dead. Alright, this is going to be my last attempt. If I can't get past this, I'm going to call it a night. I would say that I have been a little bit rusty with this game. This is the first time I picked up Syndicate in a few months. By all accounts, I'm not exactly at the top of my game when it comes to countering and when it comes to shooting, but it shouldn't be this difficult.
The convoy is headed our way.
Stay with Henry. Understood.
Will do.
I'm not sure if I can get more members of my gang here. Try to hit this dynamite.
There's a thief behind me.
Oh no. No. No! Oh. After all of that, I think that was the last enemy. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I can't believe this game. This game. What? Oh. This is terrible. Usually more trouble than he's worth. I think you're quite right about that. Okay, I think with that, I'm going to call it an end to the stream. Thanks for joining me. Again, an archive of this stream will be available on our YouTube channel, History Respawn, on probably tonight, within the hour. And you can also learn more about History Respawn at our website, historyrespawn.com. My colleague, John Harney, will be doing more live streams of Civilization V. Later on in the week, and if I've got some more time, I think I might try to pick up this mission again later on in the week. But until then, take it easy.